Hi guys, in this video I'll show you how to dual boot Windows 10 and Ubuntu both in legacy and UEFI mode. Let's begin. First step to dual boot Windows 10 and Ubuntu is to download Ubuntu ISO image. So open up your browser, type in Ubuntu download and hit enter. Click on the first link. The link is also in the description box below. Now click on download. As you can see, the download is now started. Our download is now complete. Now again go to your browser, type Rufus download. Click on the first link. The download link is also in the description box below. Click on this to download. Click on this arrow and select show in folder. Right click Rufus and click on run as administrator. Click on yes. First select the USB drive. You need minimum 4GB USB drive. Now click on select and select the Ubuntu ISO image. Then click on open. Click on start. Click on yes. Click on OK and click on OK again. Click on close. Now right click start menu and select disk management. You'll have to shrink any one of your partition to about 50 GB. Here I have only one partition. Just right click any one of your partition and click on shrink volume. In this box type 50,000, which means 50 GB. Then click on shrink. As you can see, 50 GB unallocated space is now created. Close disk management. Go to Windows search and type system information. Click on this. This is very important part. Check whether your BIOS mode is in legacy or UEFI and remember it, because this will help us to boot up your USB in appropriate mode. Now with your USB plugged in, restart your computer. Go inside your boot menu. It might look similar to this. So to boot up your USB in legacy mode, select the option which has only the name of the USB drive. To boot up your USB in UEFI mode, select the option which has UEFI mentioned along with the name of the USB drive. I'm in legacy mode, so I'm going to select this and hit enter. Click on install Ubuntu. Select your language and keyboard layout and click on continue. Check this box and click on continue. Select something else and click on continue. Click on free space. Then click on this plus symbol, type 40,000, which means 40 GB. Then select forward slash from this drop down and click on OK. Again click on free space and click on this plus symbol again. Now type 8,000, which means 8 GB. Then select swap area from this drop down and click on OK. Finally, you'll have to select device for bootloader installation, which is very important and crucial. If you get this wrong, then you might not be able to boot into Ubuntu. From this dropdown, select the partition in which you have this checkmark. In this case, I have the checkmark in SDA5, so I'm going to select SDA5 from this dropdown and click on install now. And click on continue. Select your location and click on continue. Now type your name, username and password and click on continue. Now click on restart now. Hit enter. If your computer boots up automatically into Windows, you are in legacy mode. Do this only when you are in legacy mode. Open up your browser. Type ECBCD download and hit enter. Click on the first link. This link is also in the description box below. Click on download now. Click on this arrow and select show in folder. Double click ECBCD and click on yes. Go ahead and install ECBCD. Click on finish. Click on go. Click on OK. Now click on add new entry. Go to Linux or BSD tab and then select GRUB2 from this drop down. Now give it a name. I am going to name it Ubuntu 20.04. And finally click on this plus symbol. As you can see, now it shows that it has been added to boot menu successfully. So now close this application and restart your computer. And now you'll see options like this. Go inside Ubuntu. Hit enter. Type your password and hit enter. Installation is almost completed now. Just a few more clicks here and there. Click on done. So this is how you can dual boot Windows 10 and Ubuntu. So that's it guys. If you find this video useful, then please consider subscribing to our channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.